At the end of this online module, you should be able to use MATLAB to compute the coefficients of a best fit linear model using least squares method, compute predicted values using the best fit linear model, compute the R squared values from SSE and SST, plot the best fit linear regression line on a plot of raw XY data, and display the best fit equation and R squared value. Let's consider a problem that will help us learn about linear regression using least squares regression in MATLAB. An engineer working within the personal computer industry wants to understand the changes in the percentage of households in the United States that own a personal computer. Using data obtained from the U.S. Census Bureau, the engineer has been tasked with modeling the change over time and verifying the quality of the model. A common method to find a best fit line is to use least squares regression. Recall from other online modules that this is the equation for the slope of the best fit line, and this is the equation for the y-intercept. Let's try to find the coefficients for our least squares regression line in MATLAB. Notice that in this script, I have already initialized my variables in the initialization section and suppressed them. From previous modules on least squares regression using this example, we know the slope for the best fit model should be 2.6 and the y-intercept should be -5,203. Okay, so I will make a block comment for finding the best fit coefficients in the calculation section, then use the equations for the slope and y-intercept to calculate the coefficients. I will call my slope slope_a and my y-intercept y_int_b. I am not going to go through each part of the code for these equations as this calculation has been covered in other modules, but note that these calculations take a lot of managing the order of operations and several places need dot operators. For example, this year times households needs the dot because they are both vectors of the same size and we want a resulting vector of the same size. On the other hand, look at the mean of the year times the mean of the households. This does not need a dot since the years and households are both vectors, and when you take the mean of a vector, you get a scalar. For each, I have added a variable comment that includes units. Okay, I will save and run to make sure I get my expected values. Good, slope_a is 2.6, and y_int_b is -5.2030 × 10³. Here, MATLAB is displaying this in scientific notation in the command window, which is fine. This is the same as -5,203. Wow, that was a lot of tedious algebra to manage in MATLAB. Did you know there is a MATLAB built-in function to do the same thing in one step? To find the coefficients of a polynomial that fits the data using least squares regression in MATLAB, we use the command POLYFIT. This command requires three input arguments: x, the independent variable, y, the dependent variable, and the degree or order of the polynomial that will best fit the data. This value should be a whole number. For this command to be useful, we need to assign it to a variable. Here, that variable is c, and is a row vector that contains the number of elements of the degree plus one more. These are all of the coefficients of the polynomial that fits the model, in order from highest degree to lowest degree. So for linear regression, or regression when we want our model to be a line, we need the degree to be one, so we put a one in the third input. And the c variable is a row vector of two elements where the first element is the slope and the second element is the y-intercept. So I will go back to my script. I'm going to suppress the slope_a and y_int_b equations and work on using POLYFIT next. I add my block comment and I will call my coefficient variable coefs. Set that equal to POLYFIT, open parentheses, then put my independent variable year, a comma, then my dependent variable households, another comma, and use one for the degree since we want it to be linear, then close my parentheses. I'll save and run. Notice that coefs is a vector with two terms, and that the first term is the same as slope_a, and the second term is the same as y_int_b. Again, MATLAB displays these in scientific notation. Okay, so in my script, I'm going to comment out the slope_a and the y_int_b and just use the coefs from here forward. I will suppress coefs so it doesn't display to the command window unformatted. I start by adding a block comment. In order to calculate the coefficient of determination in MATLAB, we have to use the equations for SSE, SST, and R squared. When I look at the SSE equation, notice that we need the y sub i's, which are stored in the variable households, and we need the f of x sub i's, which are y values calculated from the model. I will call this predicted households, since it is the y values from the model. Then I need to add the slope. We need to call it using what we've already calculated to avoid hard coding. Remember that COEFS contains the slope as the first element and the y-intercept as the second element. So if I just want the slope, I can use linear indexing to copy it. That makes the slope COEFS of 1, then multiplied by all of the x's, which is the variable year. Now to add the y-intercept, I just use plus and COEFS of 2. Let's save and run. I see I get values that make sense for the modeled y's. Just as before, there's a built-in MATLAB function that we can use instead. POLYVAL is a built-in MATLAB function that evaluates a polynomial, meaning it finds all of the y values for the polynomial if you input all of the x values. You are not required to be able to use POLYVAL in this course. If you do choose to use it, it requires two inputs. The first input, C, is the row vector that contains all of the coefficients of the polynomial going from highest degree to lowest degree. The second input is the array that contains all of the values of our independent variable. Again, for this command to be useful, we need to assign it to a variable. F is the array that contains all of our f of x sub I values. It will be the same dimension as the independent variable array entered. So when using this with linear regression, that makes the c value just the row vector with the slope as the first element and the y-intercept as the second element. So for our example, this is the COEFS variable from the script we are working on in this module. Here is the code that you would use in our script if you wanted to use POLYVAL. This would replace the predicted underscore households line we currently have in our script. However, I will leave our script as is. Now we need to continue to find the SSE. Since we have our values for f of x sub I, which is in the variable predicted underscore households, and the y sub I's are households, we can just code the SSE equation. I'm going to use SSE as my variable name. SSE equals the sum of the quantity households minus predicted underscore households, that quantity squared, with the dot operator, and I'm going to close my parentheses. Similarly, I will call the SST equation SST and use the SST equation to calculate the values. So that equals the sum of households minus the mean of households, that quantity squared. Again, notice the dot operator. Finally, I calculate R squared, which is just 1 minus SSE divided by SST. I will run again. I get that my R-squared value is 0.9687. Recall from previous modules that this is the same. The final things that need to be done are to plot the data and the modeled line and display the results of our least squares regression to the command window. I will first suppress all calculations. Then I will plot the data and modeled line in the formatted text and figure displays section. I am just going to copy and paste this for you here to review. Recall that this takes the hold on command in MATLAB and that you need to format it for technical presentation. Finally, I will display the results to the command window using fprintf. For the first line, I will just tell the user what is coming. Remember that you want to use the backslash n to move to the next line. I also added an extra one in the middle to make the words appear exactly as I wanted them to. Then in the next line, I will display the equation using fprintf, open parentheses, start a quote, leave some space for an indention, households equals percent 0.1f, open parentheses year, close parentheses, plus open parentheses, percent 0.0f, close parentheses, backslash n, close quotes. Now I need to add a comma, then my two variables. Remember that COEFS contains the slope and the y-intercept. So for the first variable, I need the slope, so I use COEFS of 1. Add a comma, then for the second variable, I need the y-intercept, so I use COEFS of 2. Then close my parentheses. I will also add text to display the coefficients of determination. Again, I will copy and paste so you can see the code. When I save and run, I see that I get a nice plot formatted for technical presentation, and the command window outputs my regression line. In summary, we learned to do linear regression using MATLAB by calculating the slope and y-intercept using the least squares regression equations. We also learned that we could use the built-in MATLAB function called POLYFIT to get the coefficients of slope and y-intercept in one variable. For POLYFIT, we must use degree 1 to force it to do linear regression, and the variable created is a row vector where the first term is the slope and the second term is the y-intercept. We also learned to calculate goodness of fit in MATLAB. First, we calculated the y values of the best fit line using the slope and intercept calculated. We also learned that there is a built-in function called POLYVAL that we can use instead, although it is not required for this course. We then calculated the r-squared by using the SSE and SST equations. To display our results, we plotted the data and modeled line on the same plot and formatted it for technical presentation, and we used fprintf to display the regression equation and r-squared value to the command window.